Hello everyone, welcome to this video. In this video, we'll be talking about natural language processing. So if you know about the project that Google came up with, where your Google Assistant will talk to your clients, it'll talk to your friends, it'll talk to your mom, and she won't come to know if there is an original person talking or it's a machine which is talking. So how did they really do that? Like, what was the tech behind it? So one part of the whole project, a small part of the project though, is basically natural language processing. So this concept tells the machine how to talk, how to frame the sentence, and which word to stress on more, and how to even speak that word. So how do they do that? While doing machine learning, while doing a processing, these are the six steps that actually they follow. So going through all the steps, first step is tokenization. For example, machine is learning, I will go for football match. And how do you really speak, like while learning how a person is speaking? What it'll do is basically in tokenization, it'll remove all the tags of the sentence. For example, I go football match. Now it understands. It doesn't need to understand will and for, because that is a part of sentence. That is a flow of sentence. But the tags are I go football match. So tokenization has been done. Now, same sentence could have been like I will go for football match, which almost makes the same sense, right? So that cleaning part of the whole tag, like, will be done by stemming. So stemming, what it does is basically converts all those words like going or go into just one word, go. So it cleans up your tags, which is very important if you realize, right? So it needs to understand what you really mean. To do that, you have to go back to the original word which has been used in the sentence. So stemming is for that. Third part is lemmatization. Lemmatization basically converts, for example, I will go for football match, I went for football match, I'm going for football match. Basically in go, went, and going, or gone, all these words they actually are derived from go. So if I see went, so the meaning of the sentence should not really change. It's still the same. So that will be done by lemmatization, where it converts other words which are very similar to each other into one original word. That has been done by lemmatization. The major one, the most important, which actually makes sentence meaningful, is pause tag. What pause tag does is basically from the sentence itself, it'll recognize which one is a verb, which one is an adverb, or all of those tags will be done in pause tag. So let's just say Manipal. So Manipal can be used just as place. But for example, the name like a lion, there can be a company which is lion, or there can be an animal in the sentence which is lion. So what that sentence really means, what is the reference to that word, will be actually processed and be known in pause tag. So in this, we actually tag noun, pronouns, adverbs, and all of these things in pause tag. This is very important, so I'm stressing onto it. So if you want to read more about it, let me know. I'll provide you links from where I read this. And it's really interesting. I love this part. And the second last is named entity recognition. So in this portion, the machine really understands if that part is a location or a name or a place or a time. For example, football match. Now, football match can also be an event. It can also be a club event. It can also be just a place. So it can be anything as such. It can be like match can also be a lot of different things. So what word means what in this particular sentence will be given by named entity recognition. If it's a name, it's a location, if it's a it's something else, maybe Google can also be a place, it can also be a website. So that kind of sense will be recognized in this particular portion. And the last one is chunking, where all the tags that you have taken, cleaned, lemmatization has been done, noun pronunciation has been done, what you really mean to say, if it's a place or a person, everything else has been done, everything has been cleaned and refined. Now all those words will be put in a proper form using pause tag to make a sentence or make a word. So now what, after you say I will go for a football match, all the six things will be done and machine will understand I go football match. So it understood the context of the sentence. So this is how natural language processing works. If you have any questions, you can let me know in the comment section below, and thank you for watching.